Hi, and welcome to another Shotcut tutorial. Today, I will show you an easy way to draw an animated pathline on a map. For this, you will need to have at least the 22.06.23 version of Shotcut installed on your computer, since we will use the recently added Glaxnimate plugin. On this map, I will use Glaxnimate to trace a line from this location to that location. So let's import the map image in Shotcut and start the tutorial. The first step is to decide how long you want the animation to last. It will be overlaid on top of this image clip. In my Shotcut settings, the default length of an imported image is 4 seconds. This is a little too short, so I will need to make the image clip a little longer. 7 seconds should be enough. To adjust the duration of the clip, grab its end and drag it to the right. Also, like I said a moment ago, the Glaxnimate animation file will be on a track above the image clip, so I need a second track in my timeline. To create the animation, go to Open Other and choose Animation Glaxnimate. Change the duration to 7 seconds and leave the background color to transparent. Choose the location where you want to save the file. Edit the file name if you want, and click on Save. This will launch Glaxnimate. We will draw the lines in this preview panel, but to know where to draw those lines, we need to see our background image. Click on the Save button and go back to the Shotcut window. It is not visible, but the animation file is now loaded in the source panel. Grab inside the panel and drag the Glaxnimate file on track V2. Click on the Edit button in the Properties panel. And go back to the Glaxnimate window. You should see the map in the preview panel now. If you position the mouse cursor in the preview panel, you can use your mouse wheel to zoom out and zoom in on the image. Also, you can press and hold the mouse wheel and move the mouse to see a different section of the image. You will use the Draw Bezier tool to draw the lines on the map. If you don't see this toolbar, go to View, Toolbar, and check the Tools option box. Click on the Draw Bezier button. This should automatically open the Tool Options tab. I don't know exactly yet what is the difference between these three options, but when I prepared for the tutorial, I used Group, and it worked fine. These two options let you configure the properties of the object you will be drawing. With both of them active, Glaxnimate will create a shape with a stroke that will be filled with a background color. Since you just want to draw a line, you need to disable the fill option. Now let's learn how the Bezier tool can be used to draw a broken line. Select the Draw Bezier tool and make sure that only the stroke option is enabled. Choose where you want to start the line, then click and release the left mouse button. Move the cursor to the next position and click again. Move to another position and click again. Move and click again. This will be the end of this line for now. To release the Bezier tool from the line, press the Enter key on your keyboard. The line is complete, and a new path was added to the Layers panel. Open this path and select the stroke layer. This will allow us to set the thickness, shape, and color of the stroke. Open the Stroke panel. In the Style tab, we can set the width of the stroke. I'll set mine to 8 to fit the width of the streets on the map. These icons are used to set the shape of the stroke ends. It is currently set to square. You can also make them round. Or you can remove them. I will set them to round. These icons will change the shape of the corners of the line. Right now it is set to miter, but you can also choose to have round corners. Or beveled corners. I'll choose the round corners. Switch to the color tab. This is pretty straightforward here. You can change the color, the saturation, the value, or the opacity. I want my stroke to be red, so I'll choose this color. I will delete this path and we can now start to draw the real itinerary on the map. The line I want to draw will start on this location and will end here using this itinerary. Position the cursor and left-click once to start the line. Move the cursor to the next position and click again. And so on, until you reach the destination. Note that I don't really pay attention to all the curves of the streets. I just draw a rough itinerary for now. I will do the fine-tuning later. Now that the stroke is complete, I will zoom in and edit the line to make it follow exactly the shape of the streets. Click on the Edit Tool button. You can now see all the junctions points in the line. These are called nodes. You can grab any of these nodes and move it anywhere you want. Here we see that this part of the line should be bent a bit. So I will add a new node here. To do this, click on the Add Node icon and move the cursor near any part of the line. This small blue dot indicates where the node will be added. When it is near the position where you want the node, click on the left mouse button. Grab the new node and move it. Do this on the entire itinerary until you are satisfied with the shape of the line. All done. If I press play now, nothing will happen, of course. This is just a static line. We need to add an animation to it. To do this, go to the Layers menu. Open the New submenu and select Trim Path. A new Trim Path layer is added. Make sure it is selected and click on this button to move it to the bottom of the layers list. I'll expand the timeline to be able to see the trim path parameters. The start parameter is set to 0%. This means the line will start to be visible at the very beginning of the path. If I change this value to 20% and hit enter, the first 20% part of the line will be hidden. At 40%, the first 40% of the line will be hidden. Same thing with the end parameter. If I set it to 80%, the last 20% of the line will be hidden. We will now use keyframes to animate the drawing of the line. First, make sure the playhead is at the very start of the timeline, on frame 0. Double-click on the end value, and change it to 0%. Then press Enter. Right-click, and choose Add Keyframe. Move the playhead to the last frame of the timeline. Double-click on the end value, and change it to 100%. Right-click, and choose Add Keyframe. As I move the playhead backward and forward, you can see the value of the end parameter decreasing and increasing as the line moves between the start position and the end position. And here's how it looks if I play the animation from the first frame. The animation part is done. Click on the Save button, and go back to the Shotcut window. The Glaxnimate file has been updated in Shotcut. This trim path feature of Glaxnimate can be used for many things. Here are a few examples. Highlighting text. Outline people or objects. Draw animated box borders. Or draw any kind of shapes.